Chief guest Dr. Kunal Sarkar will be in conversation with the authors. Let me introduce Nidhi Poddar and Sushil Poddar to you formally. Nidhi Poddar faced formidable challenges while parenting her inspiring son, Divyansh Arman, Atman. The protagonist of Blaze, A Son's Trial by Fire, which she co-authored with her husband, Sushil Poddar. These challenges eventually transformed a homemaker into an author. Sushil Poddar is a senior government officer who has been serving his department for the last 27 years and is presently posted as Commissioner of Income Tax, Mumbai. He is co-author of Blaze, A Son's Trial by Fire. We also have Dr. Kunal Sarkar, who is a leading cardiac surgeon and past president of Indian Association of Cardiothoracic Surgeons, IACTS. He is currently senior vice chairman and chief cardiac surgeon of Medica Hospitals Private Limited, Kolkata, and chairman Kolkata Heart Foundation, KHF. Okay. That's fine then. Dr. Sahab says keep it at that. Let's go further. Okay, Anjum says please read it fully. An avid debater, he founded the Calcutta Debating Circle, CDC, which hosts Calcutta's Festival of the Spoken Word, India's largest debating festival. His recently published title, The Sickness of Health, that's quite a title. Narrates the journey of Indian healthcare. Welcome Nidhi, Sushil and Kunalji, and over to you for the conversation. If everyone could settle down please, then we'll all be able to listen to the conversation nicely. Thank you.
Sure.
And could we welcome them with a heartwarming round of applause. Thank you.
Into the fire, my friends, look at its profoundness and rekindle the fire in you to make the spirit strong, stronger than ever before.
Thank you and good afternoon. Friends, it's not very common that you find a doctor sitting within a shake hand distance with an income tax commissioner. But, life is strange. Today, we start the session with a note of gratitude that Anjum and Valley of the Words took this great opportunity to bring both Sushilji and Nidhi to Kolkata. I think where we sit over here, what is it, 1826, 1827, when the Bengal Renaissance is just about coagulating. And if you look back, what was happening in the spectrum of medicine in that era of the 19th century, that was the time when some meaningful work was happening in oncology, in cancer work. Some of the first papers, some of the first insightful researches into hemato-oncology came out in that era between 1830s to 1850s. We go into that later. Somebody mentioned fire in the introduction to the book. Fire in all its perspective, the heat, the light, the warmth, everything put together, I think these two people have been through it. And they not only faced up to one of the most sternest challenges of human existence, of human ethos, but after all that was over, they put their very simple and very sincere recollections in the form of this book that we hold in front of us today. And this is a journey, friends. If you've read this book, which I have, you know, if you've read this book from cover to cover, I think you should spend as much time reading the book as you should spend thinking about this book. This should make you think. This should make you internalize the many challenges that some of us probably so far have been fortunate not to encounter. Very brave people who have given the strength of relationship of humanity an entirely different definition altogether. Nidhi and Sushilji, welcome to Kolkata.
Thank you.
And you know, this was a long journey, wasn't it? A decade. Yes. This was not a challenge you faced. You know, we faced pandemics when about a matter of weeks and months, families were being turned inside out, you know, relationships were completely shattered. You fought it out for 10 years. And in your journey over 10 years, you know, when a family, I think Divyansh was around 12 when you first detected this problem. So from both of you, when a family, you know, a technocratic middle class family of our country faces up to a challenge like this, how did you formulate your mind? Was it a mixture of despair, or was it a kind of co-gen strategy that this is how we face up to the challenge? Because there is both a medical aspect to it and a human aspect.
If I can take it forward, no, today I can answer all those questions.
Yes.
When this problem came to us, I could not have visualized how to face this. In what way despair, challenge, you know, agony, and strategize your treatment process, making a good strategy how to deal with the doctors. Now we can look back and talk about it. When it came, it was a, you know, shock. And we are a normal human being. We had to be shocked, and we were shocked. Now the next question was, what to do? The doctors came in, they started the process. But the best, there was despair, but the best part was that we never thought about death, never ever. And that's why if you read this book, there is no discussion of death till the last paragraph of the last chapter. We never talk about that. We only thought brighter future amidst medical crisis or maybe some side effects. So there was no agony to that level. Then as a family, of course, we were crestfallen, and more the mother was crestfallen. But the only person which gave us strength, we talk about society supports you, family supports you, it's a fact, they support you, but the biggest support, and let me tell you with my own experience, with the experience of my son Divyang, the protagonist of this story, the biggest strength one can get is from oneself only. And the strength I got when I saw my son grappling with this medical problem, humongous problem, he was like a very cool chap. He was cool, he was writing poetry. And then if he feels like this, how can I not? I used to get, and then I thought, this is the person, we have to derive strength from ourselves only. There were persons coming to us, and they actually multiplied our problems. They would come, oh, what happened? You have cancer. No, this mindset, as a person who had suffered this problem, and he, as doctor, he will also say like this, we must shed this outlook. If it's a cancer, my son was taking treatment, if you allow me, I can take it forward. My son was taking treatment in Jerusalem, Israel. He was undergoing bone marrow transplantation. And I said, Divyans, what difference you find here? You have been taking treatment in Mumbai, now in Israel. What difference you are finding here?
Sushil, you will come to the treatment, yeah. that challenge a bit. I mean, I don't know, you know, they are not very pleasant days to go back to, maybe, but was there any difference, the way you reacted, the way Sushilji reacted to this? Did both of you require some time to formulate a plan or a strategy that this is how we go ahead?
ये ब्लेज एक बेटे की जर्नी है और मदर अपने सन की जर्नी बता रही है, तो मैं बताना चाहूंगी कि ऐसा कुछ हम लोगों ने सोचा नहीं लास्ट 10 इयर्स में. बस जो जो एडवर्सिटी आई, हम लोगों ने उसको चैलेंज के तरह लिया और आगे बढ़ता रहा. बहुत टाइम नहीं मिला हम लोगों को कुछ प्लान करने का या सोचने का कि अगर ऐसा हुआ है तो हम लोग आगे कैसे प्लान करेंगे. जैसे ही कुछ प्लान आता, बुक में आप पढ़ेंगे, फिर नया कुछ चैलेंज आता, फिर हम लोग नए चैलेंज के लिए निकल पड़ते थे दिव्यांश के साथ. और एज अ मदर, कोई भी मदर नहीं सोच सकती है कि ऐसे उसका बेटा चला जाएगा उसके सामने से, लेकिन ऐसा हुआ. लेकिन अभी भी शायद मैं नहीं सोच पा रही हूँ कि वो नहीं है, वो शायद बुक के फॉर्म में है और हमेशा के लिए है, और लोगों को शायद एक मैसेज देने इस वर्ल्ड में आया था और शायद उसका पर्पस पूरा हुआ है. तो मैं अब लाइफ को ऐसे ही लेती हूँ. और ये अनयूजुअल है कि एक मदर अपने बेटे की लेगेसी को आगे लेके जा रही है, और कितने दूर तक जा पाऊँगी मुझे नहीं पता है.
निधि, इसमें एक बात और भी है कि ये जो 10 साल से आपका, when I was reading, yes, I soch raha tha ki this is like a pilgrimage.
Yes.
You know, it's a pilgrimage of human relationship which is going on for a decade. Aur isme kuch intervals aise thi when I think things were almost normal hota ja raha.
Yeah.
Nahin?
Yes.
Ye tha nahin? There was, yes.
It was roller coaster.
Especially, I think, the period of time jab aap log USA mein thi.
Yes.
To USA mein thi, you could see, you could almost visualize the light in his eyes.
Yeah,
a young man, a young boy is thinking of his career. Mm-hmm. He's thinking of US getting into a university.
Mm-hmm.
Wo kaisa padhai aage karenge, wo aisa soch rahe the. So I think ye jo, it's like this one bolte hai na, ke roller coaster ride hai, upar niche ja rahe hai. You are pendulating violently between normality and challenge. I think ये भी काफी मुश्किल काम है.
मुश्किल नहीं था वहाँ, यूएस में लगा कि अब सेटल हो जाएगा, मुझे उसका ब्राइट फ्यूचर दिख रहा था. तो मैंने एक नया ड्रीम उसके लिए शुरू किया कि वो, क्योंकि अच्छा लिखता था, पोएट्री अच्छी थी और थॉट बहुत अच्छे थे, यूनिक थे उतने कम एज में. तो मैंने उसके लिए ड्रीम देखा था कि कभी वो ऑथर बनेगा, और यहाँ शायद दिव्यांश को बैठना चाहिए था, मैंने वो ड्रीम देखा था. तो वो ड्रीम ने मुझे कभी बहुत दुखी और निराश नहीं होने दिया. जब भी कुछ ऐसा पेन देखती थी मैं, तो मैं उसका ब्राइट फ्यूचर देखती थी. लेकिन दिव्यांश चला गया तो ऐसा नहीं था कि अब मेरा ड्रीम टूट जाए, और उससे भी पता था मेरी मम्मी मुझसे क्या चाह रही है. तो उसके जाने के बाद फिर एक नई जर्नी हम लोगों की शुरू हुई, और दिव्यांश के साथ ही, उसके बिना नहीं. और जो भी अगर बुक में आप पढ़ेंगे तो बोलते हैं एग्जाम के पहले आप छोटे छोटे पॉइंटर बना देते हैं और उसके बाद एक्सपेंड करते हैं जितना करना है। तो दिव्यांश ने जाने के पहले अपने लाइफ को छोटे छोटे चीज़ों में दे के गया था और हम लोगों ने बस उसके चीज़ों को इस बुक के थ्रू लोगों को बताना चाह रहे हैं। और शायद कुछ लोग इंस्पायर हो तो लगेगा इस बुक का पर्पस और दिव्यांश का पर्पस और हम लोगों का भी पर्पस इस वर्ल्ड में आने का शायद कुछ हद तक पूरा हो पाया।
सुशील जी, इन योर इफ वी टेक योर सॉर्ट ऑफ मेडिकल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द जर्नी, आई थिंक इट्स बीन अ व्हाइल इन जेरूसलम, हदासा हॉस्पिटल।
यस,
आई हैव एक्चुअली बीन देयर, वेरी नाइस हॉस्पिटल। A chap who was a cardiac surgeon who trained us, from a surgeon he went to Israel and became a rabbi.
Okay.
So they have very strange ways of very unique ways of life over there. You have contrasted in your book. I don't want to dwell on that for a substantial length of time, but what I the aspect I think is the human interface of medicine. Medicine is not only about a funny cocktail of drugs, molecules, intervenors, drips, infusions, and newfound protocol. Medicine also has a constant presence of a human interface. I think therein probably you contrast your experience between Israel and the United States.
Okay. Yes, you're right. In fact, like any profession, I'm in tax department, you are medical field, it has inbuilt service element. You have to serve the society. In what way? Consider deemed fit. But the question is, when you are going to serve the society, there has to have some personal element, human element. So this medical service also has to have some human element. Let me tell you an experience. What he is saying, there is contrasting experience between what I got in Israel and what in USA. USA, I'm sorry to say, but that's how the system works there. They work on binary system, 0 and 1. Either switch it off, switch it on. There's nothing between 0 and 1. And what I think, in medical science, there is a huge journey between 0 and 1. And they need to explore that. We are doing this in India, and Israelis are much, much ahead of us. I'll give an example. And it's, this particular incident is quoted in the book. It's my personal life. I have written this with unflinching honesty here. 2015, my son went
is
there.
Dr. Ruben Orr. Yes, yes.
And let me, I was shell shocked there. When I went there and my son was to go for transplantation, there is a procedure before transplantation that's called ablation chemo. Mm. You know, and radiation. Now, ablation chemo is a higher form of chemo. Your whole body cells are destroyed. Now, just before ablation chemo, and let me remind you, in 2050, before 2050, my son had already undergone 6 years of chemotherapy. While he was just, he had become adolescent, he was approaching 18 years. Now, there is a doctor there, Dr. Avni Bhatia. He called me, and it's a very interesting story. She told me, look, after this chemotherapy, the fertility of your son will go down substantially. Now what you do, you store his seed in the sperm bank. And I said, the doctor in Mumbai never told me. But doesn't a cancer patient have right to live with dignity? They never told us. And then finally we did that. So this is the aspect I'm trying to drive at. Every person, there is a huge lie between the moment you are diagnosed with cancer, unfortunately, and the death. There's a huge life. And this stereotyping has to break someday. You have to evolve. There's a huge lot of, you know, big path you have to travel. And my son showed that. He evolved during this process. And we evolved during this process.
A short part of the treatment, I think, is a bit of a funny thing to say, it's almost the closing acts of his time was in Mumbai.
Yes.
In the TLC rehab.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Did we show you enough sympathy? Did we show you enough empathy? when, how was your Indian experience? Very difficult. I think that was a very complex period.
On the contrary, when we came back to India from USA, we were pleasantly surprised. The doctors, we used to, you know, keep, you know, slightly at bay. We started loving them because we had a very torrid experience in USA. So we started loving Indian doctors again. So the therapists were very good, doctors were very good, and in fact we have weaved a relationship. How a silent person can communicate so effectively when words are falling short.
Very true.
And this is a book is you know, we have tried to demonstrate that particular aspect of communication also.
Sushilji, I think we are perhaps time is at a premium. And to discuss Blaze in all of 20 minutes is like being on a coin-operated ventilator. So I have experience of that. You know, if you go to the Edinburgh Museum of Medicine, you do see a coin-operated ventilator there. So the patient had to put coins in it to stay alive. So that is how pecuniary medicine can become. I have a photograph of that actually. Right. It is the social support.
Mm-hmm.
Medicine hai, hospitals hai, sab kuch hai.
Mm-hmm.
People around you. Aap itne sare jo aapke relatives, mm-hmm. bahut sare character people you have mentioned in the book. So all in all, jisko hum society, your people mm-hmm. around you, wo aapka saath diya yahan pe in your struggle. The human support of yours.
Mujhe lagta hai jab sab kuch aap ek saath सोसाइटी के साथ चलते रहते हैं तो सब कुछ बैलेंस में अच्छा लगता है, लेकिन आप अगर थोड़ा सा पीछे हो जाए तो मुझे लगता है सोसाइटी भी चेंज हो जाती है, वो देखने का नज़रिया भी चेंज हो जाता है, एक सिंपैथी और एक आँख में अलग फील आता है, तो लोग आप बचना चाहते हैं लोगों से. कुछ लोगों का सपोर्ट होता है, लेकिन कुछ लोग होते हैं कि आपको एक अलग तरीके से देखते हैं. आपके घर से जो हॉस्पिटल का रास्ता होता है, मैं तो बहुत बार मरीन ड्राइव से जाती थी तो मुझे कुछ भी सुंदर नहीं दिखता था क्योंकि मुझे बॉम्बे हॉस्पिटल जाना रहता था. तो घर से हॉस्पिटल का लाइफ बिल्कुल भी चेंज है, वो एक पेशेंट और उसके केयर गिवर ही फील कर सकते हैं. और उसके लिए आपको खुद में ही स्ट्रेंथ लाना पड़ेगा और लोगों का को फेस करना पड़ेगा कि मेरे पास प्रॉब्लम है तो ठीक है, मुझे ही फाइट करना पड़ेगा. अगर आप थोड़ा सा भी गिरेंगे तो लोग आपको बहुत अलग नज़र से देखते हैं, जो मैंने 10 years में फील किया. और दिव्यांश ने इस चीज को तोड़ा उसने.
Very true.
वो
सुशील जी, इन द लास्ट फ्यू मिनट्स, इफ यू अलाउ मी, आई विल प्रोबेबली एंड द सेशन बाय रीडिंग अ फ्यू लाइंस फ्रॉम
दिव्यांश. प्लीज प्लीज, प्लेजर.
एंड इज देयर एनी अदर पॉइंट यू वुड लाइक टू मेक बिफोर वी?
आई जस्ट वांटेड टू डिस्कस दिस कवर.
यस, एब्सोल्युटली, द कवर ऑफ
कवर. कैन आई?
प्लीज प्लीज गो अहेड, गो अहेड.
दिस कवर इज रियल कवर. And this was finale shot of my son before he went to the higher realm. It was 1st May 2019. 2nd May he passed away. And my wife Nidhi was sitting by his bedside in the hospital holding her hands like this. And I was quite emotional. I knew he was going to leave us one day after. And I also lot of emotional stirring up going inside my body. I thought ki this picture I can never visualize in future. I can never see. Let me click this moment. And without she even knowing about it, I clicked the photograph. And I never knew ki this is going to become a cover photo of his book someday. Now that if you see this photograph, the upper hand is Divyansh, the lower is of Nidhi. A mother is telling story of her son through this book. So both are holding hands of each other. That's what I wanted to mention. Thank you.
So touching and so real. When you mentioned, aap bole na ke Divyansh is to write poetry, I think his journey, his brief journey of 22 years in this world, almost seems to be the journey of a mystic, of a poet and a mystic. And I think he has how many? About 27 full poems he's written?
Yeah.
Around 27, which you've gathered very systematically in this book. So I think it will be a fitting closure to this session to read a few lines from Divyansh. This is the poem which he titles as Halfway Down the path not taken. I was a very young boy then, with not a care in the world, going through the prime of childhood like any other would, standing at the end of the road, adolescence as it is called. I was about to change my track to the larger one called youth. For the pressure of time, we skipped a few paragraphs and come to the closure of this poem, when Divyansh says, "Today, as I stand on this path, trying to look ahead, I don't know what lies in front of me, so I look within. Hope, determination, and courage are the sturdy boots that will steer me forward on this long and bemusing path." You can never leave Calcutta without Tagore ending your session. And in the words of our poet, I tell you that when life ends, Tagore writes in the year when he lost both his wife and his younger daughter. So how does the poet react to death at that time? He says, "Death is not extinguishing a light. It is putting out the lamp, because the dawn is at hand. The dawn through blaze is at hand, ladies and gentlemen." We remain in your text.